it's years of bullying, either that's been ignored, not dealt with, you know, lack of family support at home, and then lack of support at school.
People don't realize, you know, they think something's a joke, and then it's not a joke when the other person doesn't like it.
Sweet and divine, razor of mine.
Say pretty consistently, the students that I've dealt with that have been bullied just feel hopeless. They feel it'll never get better. There's nothing that you can say or do that's going to make things better. School's supposed to be a safe place. Some feel angry, and that's where I think school violence comes in.
The disturbing part is the actions that kids are taking to bully each other.
The anger turns inward and they just feel like they want to get revenge on the kids.
To tell you the truth, everybody thinks about it. When you've been pushed to the point where you have no outlets, where you have only yourself and your thoughts, the justification that everybody knows as a school shooting is the only thought running through your head.
The amount of things available to kids and that kids think about doing and can do versus the stuff I could have done or gotten a hold of when I was your age is like, it's not even a fraction. You know, when I was your age, I wouldn't have even dreamed of some of the stuff that kids can do to themselves.
Andre?
One.
Andre?
Two.
We can get you
three.
Out of this. Why don't you just take a...
I think it's mainly when a student feels, I think it's year after year of just being treated, abused, tormented. You know, it could be abuse going on at home and then they come to school and they're being treated the same way.
Moving on is the hardest part. And just forgiving and forgetting and making peace with everybody that had done anything to you is just relieving. And it doesn't happen with everybody. That's why it's the hardest part.
think we could ever get every kid in this building to be nice to each other?